Thank you very much indeed.
Well, Theresa May will stand down as Prime Minister later this afternoon. The political obituaries, when she announced she was going to go, well, they weren't kind, were they? So what will her legacy in Northern Ireland be defined by? Back in July 2016, Theresa May made this commitment.
David Cameron has led a one-nation government, and it is in that spirit that I also plan to lead. Because not everybody knows this, but the full title of my party is the Conservative and Unionist Party. And that word unionist is very important to me. It means we believe in the union, the precious, precious bond between England, Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland. But it means something else that is just as important. It means we believe in a union not just between the nations of the United Kingdom, but between all of our citizens, every one of us, whoever we are and wherever we're from.
Theresa May back in 2016, but did she deliver on the union? What will her legacy be? Let's talk to Felicity Houston, who is a Northern Ireland Conservative member and businesswoman, and Joey Jones, who was spokesperson for Theresa May when she was Home Secretary. Good morning. You are both very welcome.
Good morning.
Felicity, in your view, what was Theresa May's contribution to this place?
Well, I suppose due to a combination of circumstances, not really in her planning, we did end up like centre stage throughout the past couple of years due to the DUP ending up being sort of in control or holding the balance of power in Parliament. And then with all the stuff about the backstop. So suddenly people who, I don't think even knew Northern Ireland existed or certainly didn't know very much about us, suddenly found out all about us. I mean, Lord Adonis is never out of the place now, and I'm not sure he'd ever visited before Theresa May embarked on her disastrous Brexit negotiations.
Do you think Theresa May understood this place even before she signed the backstop?
I don't think so. I'm not sure really what message she was getting from her officials and the people over here who briefed Number 10. I never got the feeling that she was particularly knowledgeable about us. You know, some of our more unusual aspects of our social policies, etc. I doubt if she knew anything about again until it became suddenly a cause célèbre in the Westminster bubble.
Joey Jones, Brexit means Brexit and we're going to make a success of it. A pretty damning political epithet.
I think that nobody can pretend that it's been anything other than a huge disappointment, Theresa May's period in government. I felt that when she decided that she, or acknowledged that she had to step away and to resign, that the magnitude of that failure might crowd in on her. It's actually, to her credit to some extent, that it's looked as though, the cares of the world have been lifted from her. But there is no doubt, and I think that Felicity, it's fair comment what she's saying about the fact that the Prime Minister probably didn't understand the intricacies of what she was dealing with in terms of Northern Ireland. But then her cabinet colleagues understood it still less. There were people like one Boris Johnson, our new Prime Minister, who signed up to the backstop only, you know, 6-8 months ago to basically realise what it actually meant and to resign. So
does that include the Secretary of State, Karen Bradley, her representative in Northern Ireland as well?
Well, Karen Bradley, as you'll remember, I'm sure very well, she gave an interview to the House magazine where she laid bare the scale of her ignorance about Northern Ireland to an extent that I think was pretty astonishing for all of us around Westminster and throughout the United Kingdom. The one thing I would say about Theresa May is that she did understand right from the very start the extent to which Brexit might unravel the union. I was actually in the car with her on the morning of the referendum, travelling back in from her constituency, and listening to the press conference that you'll remember was given by Michael Gove and Boris Johnson, their victorious press conference. And there was one point when I think it was Boris Johnson said that the result would actually strengthen the union. And there was a distinct harumphing, if you like, from the then Home Secretary who was sitting next to me in the back of the car, because she recognised that was not going to be the case.
So the Prime Minister, who described herself as an arch unionist, someone who believed wholeheartedly in the union, perhaps did more to damage it than anyone else, Felicity.
Well, I don't know, that's a bit rough, but I do think that to say she, you know, she's a unionist, and it's a romantic thing, it's how our country is set up, etc., etc. Of course, and she's Blair was believed strongly in devolution and in many ways the separation of the units of our country. Theresa obviously didn't have that view. But I don't think she actually went out of her way to damage things. I just think, you know, that is part of the ineptitude of what we have seen over the past 2 to 3 years, which has brought us to this chaotic situation. If we had left when we were supposed to, I think things would have been resolved by now. But because of this constant dilly-dallying, faffing about, etc., things are not good, and the union, I mean, the Scots are back at wanting another referendum, etc., etc. Things are not good as far as the union's concerned. But I don't think she actually went out of her way to do it. I think it's just more evidence of her not being a good Prime Minister, unfortunately.
Felicity Houston and Joey Jones, thank you.